It was Motzi Shabbos, and the students of the Baal Shem Tov knew that he was going to be traveling, as heaven had informed him of some new misfortune that was in the world. And sure enough, after the Malava Malka meal, the Baal Shem Tov told his driver Alexei to saddle up the carriage, and the Baal Shem Tov took with him two of his students, Reb Dov and Reb Tzvi Sofer. As soon as the three had climbed into the carriage, the Baal Shem Tov was the first to speak, and he said, "You should know it's very important that we occupy ourselves with self-sacrifice in the mitzvah of redeeming captives. Indeed, my father, Rabbi Eliezer, grew up in a small village called Okopi. And it happened one time that a group of robbers came and ransacked the whole village. They took everything, and they took everyone as captives. But as they were leaving, the chief robber looked at the others and said, 'What profit will we gain from these old women? Better to leave them here and take the men.' And so they did. And my father was taken and sold, just as Joseph was sold as a slave, to a government minister. And my father managed to one time give this minister good advice about how to conquer a large fortress. And soon enough, my father was raised to the status of a minister himself. And the king of this far-off country gave his daughter to my father as a wife, but my father never touched her. And when she asked him why not, he said, 'If you swear yourself into secrecy, I'll tell you.' And so she did. My father told her that he was a Jew, and that he had been taken and brought to this land, and that his wife is back home, all alone, waiting for him. The princess was so taken by his pureness of heart that she gave him money and sent him on a ship to go home to his wife. However, the sailors on the ship robbed my father of everything, and he returned home just as penniless as when he had left. Although he did merit one thing, he merited to meet Eliyahu HaNavi, who had blessed my father that in this merit and in the merit of his devotion to his wife, he would be blessed with a son that would be a light to all the Jewish people." And sure enough, the Baal Shem Tov turned to his students and he said, "Did you know that my soul originates from this idea, this concept of Pidyon Shavuim, release of captives? My father was redeemed by a great miracle that was done for him. And not everyone merits to have these great miracles. It doesn't happen every day. In fact, right now, there's a nobleman that has taken captive an innkeeper and his whole family. He keeps them shackled up in his dungeon, and he set the bail so high that no one can help them. They cry out, but no one can even hear them, except for heaven. When heaven heard the cries of this family, they informed me and told me that since I am the son of a tzaddik that was redeemed by Hashem through a great miracle, I must devote my life of self-sacrifice to this mitzvah of redeeming the captives of this generation from all the harsh judgments and all the mean rulers and masters that put them through pain and toil. It's the Baal Shem Tov that they say, before he was revealed, the Jews used to look back at the temple and this exile that we find ourselves in and cry and lament. But when the Baal Shem Tov was revealed and his teachings started to spread, the Jews started to look forward towards the new base of Mikdash that will be here any second now, and we got hope. Yesterday, on the 18th of Elul, was the birthday of the Baal Shem Tov and the Alter Rebbe. It should be in his merit that we are redeemed immediately, that we have the new base of Mikdash, and that until then, we continue to have hope and know that Mashiach will be revealed any second now, and that Hashem will redeem us just as he redeemed the father of the Baal Shem Tov. Shavua Tov, and happy birthday to the Baal Shem Tov.